to join this couple in marriage, an estate made honorable by the faithful keeping of good people in all times. It is, therefore, not to be entered into lightly or unadvisedly, but reverently, sincerely, and honestly. In marriage, two persons turn to one another in search of a greater fulfillment than either can choose alone. Marriage is a going forth, a bold step into the future. It is risking what we are for the sake of what we can be. Only in giving oneself and sharing with another can the wondrous process of growth take place. Two among us who have stood apart come now in our presence to declare their love and to be united in marriage. Marriage is an institution ordained of the very laws of our being for the happiness and welfare of humankind. To be true, this outward ceremony must be but a symbol of that which is inner and real, an exalted union of hearts that society will sanction and the state make legal, but that neither can create nor annul. Marriage is not meant for happiness alone, but for the discipline and enrichment of character. To this end, there must be a consecration of one to the other, and both to the noblest purposes of life. It is in this spirit that you are both here today. So, Caitlin, will you have Tori to be thy wedded spouse, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, through sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as you both shall live? And Tori, will you have Caitlin to be thy wedded spouse, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as you both shall live? And I assume you both have tokens of affection in the form of a ring. Alright. Caitlin, please take the ring and place it on the fourth finger of Tori's left hand and repeat after me. I, Caitlin, take thee, Tori, to be my wedded spouse. Have and hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as we both shall live. And Tori, take your token of affection, the ring, and place it on the fourth finger of the left hand. I, Tori, take me, to be my wedded spouse.
To be my wedded spouse.
To have it all from this day forward. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as we both shall live. For as much as these two persons have solemnly promised to live together forever, I therefore, ministering in the name of the highest ideals of humankind and to the authority